Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Just Chem Gokul, and this is how my channel looks. There are lots of educational resources that are available on the channel, so if it does interest you, then I would recommend that you like, you share and you subscribe it with your fellow watchers. All right, so what is it that I'm bringing to you today? So today I'm going to tell you about use of Audacity and OpenShot to collaboratively put together educational resources. If you have a YouTube channel, if you are a YouTuber and you require to post educational content or any other content on YouTube, then these tools will come in really very handy for you, because you would require to edit your audio, to remove the noise and make your audio quality much better. So let's get started. Okay, hi guys, welcome back again. So what we are doing today is try to import a video file into Audacity so that we can improve the audio quality there, right? So let's get started. So this is the Audacity platform, and we can import files by going to file and say import, right? Now, before you are able to import audio from a video file, you must know that Audacity does not support video file formats by default. So you require a plugin called as FFmpeg. Okay, lots of resources are available on how to download this plugin and what is the official site for download of this plugin. Once you have this plugin installed, then you'll be able to make imports of all your video file formats to your Audacity, right? So I've already done that, so I'm just going to go ahead and import an audio file from the video. So I'll say import audio, and now I get some video files also listed that I can import. Say for example, I want to import this file here. So it says importing FFmpeg, right? So only if the plugin is there, you'll be able to import from file formats which are multimedia files of the type MPEG-4 and other video file formats. Right, so let's wait for the file to come up on our workspace, and then I'll show you how to quickly make some edits so that your audio file quality can be made better. And the last focal point will be to get this audio impregnated with your video so that your educational content is ready seamlessly. Alright, so you see the audio file has been imported here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click so that I can select the audio file. I'm going to go on FX and say compressor. This is usually to improve the audio quality, so that, I mean, there are certain parts of the audio that don't get missed out because it's too loud. At the same time, parts which are too soft or feeble can also be brought apart, right? So usually Audacity by default gives you certain settings which I wouldn't recommend you to tamper with. So you can just go ahead and say okay. So it will take some time to apply the compressor settings. Once it does that, you're going to get a file which is optimized with respect to audio quality. And for any audio format that involves lecturing or talking over something, I think these default settings are good enough for your content to be very, very legible and audible to your audience. We're almost there. The compressor settings have been applied, right? The next thing to do would be to check the noise level. Okay, so now that the compressor is applied, I just zoom in a little so that I can identify parts of noise, right? And to do that, you must always let your video record for some time so that it can accumulate the background noise which is consistently there throughout your video. So I'll just take this particular section, which is the noise part, and go to effect and say noise reduction. When I do that, I get an option to get noise profile. So I get the noise profile of the background noise. Once I've done that, I double click for the entire audio file, go to effect and say noise reduction again. Now, this time when we are doing the noise reduction, the optimum settings that you can choose are to keep the noise reduction level at 20 decibels, sensitivity at about 3.5, and frequency smoothing bands at about 2. Right, so this works well, and I believe that it should work well with you where you have your educational content. Right, so once that you've set these parameters, in case they are not by default adjusted to these values, which they'll not be, once you've set them to these values, eventually it'll always throw open the same standard values with which you've been doing your audio file corrections. All right, so I click on OK and allow it to make the corrections to the audio so that it can reduce the audio there. Right, so that's gonna take about another 10 seconds for it to come through. As you know, we can save the files in two different formats using Audacity. So you can either export your audio file as a WAV file or you can export it as an MP3. Right, both these audio formats are recognizable by OpenShot, so there is no problem at all. So once you're done with improving your audio quality, all that you need to do is go to File, say Export. I'm going to export as MP3 here because the audio is not as loaded. Okay, so I'll just save the file, the audio file. It asks me certain parameters. You're free to choose whatever you like and we are good to go. So in about a minute, we would have the audio file exported into an MP3, which has all the edits that we've tried to make. Right, so what's the next step? The next step is to try and put this audio that is formatted and edited to improve audio quality onto our video file, right? So that the crux of this resource that I've created is just for you to understand how you can collaboratively use these two open source resources and tools of OpenShot Video Editor along with Audacity, so that you can merge the edited audio into your existing video. Right, so it's already exported that. So I'm going to go to OpenShot. I've already imported the video of which I have taken the audio into Audacity and made the edits. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click on this video and right click there. So I get a few options, and in that, one of the options that you can see is separate audio. Right, so what this does is it separates the audio from the video, and you have two options within that. You can either export it into a single clip whereby all channels will come into the same track, or else you could make multiple clips. As it is, I'm not interested in the existing audio of this video. I'm anyways going to delete that, so I'm going to export this into a single clip. Right, the file is a little large, so it's taking a little while. But once it's done, you're going to see an overlaid audio on top of the video strip that you see on this track. And you are free to move it to other track positions, or you're free to delete it. So you can do a lot with it eventually. Right, we're still waiting for it to finish separating the audio from this file. Once that is done, what we are going to do is we are going to go to File. We will be importing our audio that we've already finished editing using Audacity. It is going to come to our workspace here. Once that is done, we are going to import that into the second track, and we are going to export this project. So all in all, what we'll get will be the final result, that is and edited audio on the video. So what you see right now is this audio file. Do you see all the waves here? Right, so I can pick this up and put this on another track. I can even right click and remove this clip. When I do that, now this video is without audio, right? But thankfully, what I can do is I can go to File, I can go to Import Files, and there hunt down my audio file that has been edited. Now this edited audio file I drag and I place it here. Okay, now when I click on play, so now the video is playing with the edited audio overlaid on this video, right? So the last step that we need to do then is just go to file, export, and say export video. Then it'll show me the place or the destination where I want to save the video, and once you're done, there it is. You get your educational resource with an edited audio overlaid onto your video, right? So try this out, guys, and do let me know how it goes in case if you need any other help or assistance. It's pretty straightforward. You just need to separate the audio with your video that you've shot. Once you separate that, you delete off the audio file and you bring in the audio file that you've edited using Audacity. Once you put them in two different tracks, you're good to go. Just export the file into one of the formats that you may wish to, and you're good to go then. You can upload it on YouTube or any other social media platforms that you have. Thanks for being with me. Take care. I'll see you on the other side. Bye-bye.